Hello everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to convert from float data type to integer data type in C++. So I will be showing you four ways, okay, how to do this. So let's get started. So first let me declare a float variable. So it's going to be float f equal to, let's say my variable value is 1.234, okay. And the first method is like a direct method itself. So let's suppose say that I am having an integer of variable of I, okay. So first method is direct assignment. So you just put I equal to f, okay. So we are just assigning our float variable to our integer variable, and if you just go and put c out I, we will be getting 1 in the output, okay. 1 we are getting 1 in the output. Let me just change this to 5 something, okay. So this is the first method, okay, and the second method is the same as well, but instead you are just going to typecast it, okay. So you are just going to put an int over here, and let's suppose that you just want to print, you don't want this itself, you don't want a variable, an integer variable, you just want to print the float variable in the form of an integer. So in that case, this works very well. So you can just copy this and instead of I, you just paste it, and that's it. You can even assign it as well, that's not going to be an issue, but here our necessity is just converting directly in the cout. Okay, let's save it, and if I just execute now, I'll be getting only 5 in the output, which completely removes all the decimal points. Okay, so this is well and good, but there's a problem over here. The main problem by using this method is that, consider, let's say we are having 1.634, okay. So if we round something which is 1.5 and greater, we need to get the nearest largest whole number, which means that 1.6 needs to be rounded to 2 rather than 1. But if I just do this way, if I just now execute it, I'll be getting 1, but we need to get 2 because 2 is closer than 1 to 1.6, because anything greater than 1.5 needs to get rounded to the largest whole number, but it isn't happening here. And same thing with the typecasting method as well. So if you just go here and put int f, same thing, instead of 2 we will be getting 1, okay. It just gets by default rounded off to the lowest whole number, irrespective of whether it is greater than 1.5 or not. So here what happens is that we can use the round function, inbuilt function round. So what round does is that, so round, you need not to use round function, you need to import this file, okay, or C math something, but in general this does the work for us. So what you need to do is you need to just go and have an integer variable, or you can just directly print it, it's your choice. I will have an integer variable I. I'll put I equal to round of f, and we just print I, okay. So if I just execute it now, I will be getting 2 in the output. So as you can see, getting 2, the reason is because this is greater than 1.5, and with the help of round function this can be like achieved. So if I just go here and put 1.3, okay, 1.334, so this is obviously less than 1.5. so what round function does is that it just rounds off to the nearest whole number. So 1.3 is closer to 1 than 2, okay. So here it will now, so now let's just go and directly print it, okay. So cut this and paste it. So I'm just directly rounding off, just want to show this can be done this way as well. So now if we round 1.3, we will be getting 1 in the output. So we're getting 1 in the output, that's fine. And there's also another condition over here. Let's suppose say that we need to round 1.3 to 2, irrespective of any condition, we need to get this value rounded to the nearest largest whole number. So if we are having 2, it's between a range, it's between 1 to 2. But irrespective of this point value, we need only to have 2, that is the largest whole number. So in case of like 10, we need to get the, it ranges between 10 to 11, but we need to get only 11 as the output, irrespective of this value. So in that case, what we will do is, we will be using the seal method, okay. Seal, okay, seal function. So you just save it, and if I just execute it now, I'll be getting 11 in the output. So even though this number is less than 10.5, I'm getting 11 in the output, okay. And let's say that another same case, so we are having a range of 10 to 11, so how large this number can be, we need to get only the lower range as the output. So let's suppose say that I'm having 10.999, okay. So if we round off this, we will be obviously getting 11, but we need only 10 in the output. So in that case, if you put seal, we will be getting 11 only in the output. So because seal is higher range, okay, always gives the highest whole number. But if you put floor, okay, explore. So in our, you need to also use the same header file, okay? Otherwise it won't work. So if you hit floor, it just rounds off to the lowest whole number. So I'm going to 10. Even though the value is 10.99, I'm getting rounded off to 10. That's the power of floor. So all these are like integer type. So you can just assign this to my int I as well. So if I just print I, this will work. That's not going to be an issue. So it works, I'm getting 10. So these are some of the ways you can convert float data type to integer data type in C++. And I hope you have found this video useful. My program channel has many other C++ programming videos, SQL query questions, interview questions, as well as program videos in C, Java and Python, as well as 3D Machine Blender. So do check out the rest of my channel. Subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.